Hi, I'm Joseph Patrick Daniels, and this lesson is part of my series of guided drawing and painting courses, the Beginner to Master Art Academy. Lesson 1, the 10-value grayscale. Let's begin by getting you acquainted with your pencils. Your standard pencil set will come with a combination of pencils ranging from 6B down to 5H. Don't worry if yours is a little different. Each pencil can cover a range of values, so just substitute it with the number closest to it. So for example, if you don't have a 3B, use a 2B. And please follow along even if you're already familiar with the different pencil leads. This lesson is going to play an important role in how I communicate values and pencil leads to you throughout the course. The first and most basic aspect of drawing is learning what to expect from each pencil in your set. After that, it's learning how to control the pressure you're applying to your pencil. And the best way to do both of those things at once is to practice shading. To learn shading, I find that it helps to break it into 10 values. This technique is based on the Riley method, which is a relatively newer approach to teaching drawing. I won't bore you with a long history lesson, but Frank Riley was an artist in the 60s and 70s who had such an effective, organized approach to teaching painting and drawing that he went on to found a school for it. So I'm going to walk you through shading a 10-value grayscale by assigning a specific pencil lead to each value. For example, the softest lead, a 6B pencil, will shade the 10th or darkest value. And a 6H pencil, which is the hardest lead, will be second value. And first value will be untouched white paper with no lead on it. To begin, download the 10-value grayscale I created for you from the downloadable materials section of the course, and print it out on regular 8.5x11 printer paper. It should look just like the worksheet you see on screen right now. And when you're finished with this lesson, be sure to keep this chart to use as a handy reference guide to help you find the right pencil and value in the future. Let's begin with 10th value. Using your 6B pencil, begin to shade in the corresponding square and try to match the darkness of the value you see in the box to its left. When it comes to shading dark values, the rule is to gradually build them up, so don't apply full pressure all at once. Don't worry, you'll learn pressure control during this course. For now, try going over and over the area making concentric circles, as I'm doing in my demonstration. We'll get into the different shading styles in the next lesson. For now, just stay in the lines. There are a number of reasons why you should gradually build up your shading. First, if you try to apply it all at once, it'll turn shiny and the paper will buckle. I'm sure that's happened to every one of you at some point in your life, maybe with a number 2 pencil while you were bored in school. The second reason is to give you control of the darkness or lightness of a value. You'll learn how important that is later in the course. For now, just fill in the square with your 6B pencil using medium pressure, and keep going over it until it's the same value as the sample square I provided you on the left. For those of you who have some training with shading, you can try to do some hatching, but with a lead this soft, it won't stay sharp long enough to keep a fine line, so making small circles or scumbling works best. This is about how dark your first layer of shading should be. I'll go over it about 3 times to get it as dark as the square on the left. For the more advanced students who are anxious to start doing some drawing, just power through the first few lessons. We'll get to the more advanced stuff soon enough. These lessons are important because I'm going to be referring to the values as 10th, 5th, 2nd, etc. throughout the course, so I want you to get acquainted with the sort of code or language I'll be using to communicate with you. Besides, it's not a bad idea to brush up on the fundamentals, and these exercises are a good warm-up. Just keep going over the area, adding more pressure each time you pass. And when you're done, write the pencil lead you use next to the box. For 9th value, I'm going to use a 5B lead pencil. And again, you want to build up the value gradually. When you're done, the square should be about 10% lighter than the square before it, so you'll be able to see a little bit of the paper grain showing through the pencil. I'm going to speed up the pace while I'm shading. Don't worry about missing anything. I'll slow it down for new information. It's a small square, so use whatever shading technique you're comfortable with for now. In fact, this lead is just hard enough to crosshatch with. The lecture after this is an in-depth lesson on shading, so you'll learn the fundamentals of a number of different techniques, and we'll work on training out whatever bad habits you might have. I'm sure even those of you with experience will pick up something new during that section. I'm going to constantly change pencil leads during this course, so to make sure you can keep track, I'm going to have the number of the lead I'm using written here in the left-hand corner of the screen at all times. Okay, that value looks like it matches. I'll just label it with the lead I used, 5B. For eighth value, I'm going to switch to a 4B pencil. I'd like to take advantage of this time while I work to start talking about the different types of shading. For example, what I'm doing right now is called scumbling, which is just making concentric circles. It's easiest to do with softer leads, but doesn't tend to look good with the harder leads. The challenge with darker values is to try to keep them consistent, so try not to leave dark or light patches. Once we get to the lighter values, we'll start using harder leads, so we'll start to use a hatching and cross-hatching approach to shading in the value. I'll talk more about those techniques as we progress. That looks about right. If you're having trouble telling if your square is the same value as the printed square because of the pencil grain, squint your eyes and look at it. That'll help you see the average value. And when you're done, be sure to label it with the pencil you used. For seventh value, I'm going to use a 3B lead. I'm just using the same amount of pressure on this square as I was on the first three, but this lead is noticeably harder, so it's not as dark as the previous squares. And notice the size of the pencil grain is much smaller. At this point, you'll notice I've switched the pattern of my shading from scumbling to crosshatching. I want you to get used to the different leads. As we progress in this course, you'll learn that some leads are better for drawing and some are best for shading. You'll also learn that some pencils shade better with a scumbling pattern, while others shade better using a cross-hatching pattern. For example, I prefer a pencil with a hard lead, like an H, for drawing the wrinkles in a white sheet, and I prefer a softer 3B lead for drawing dark hair or eyelashes. But I'll go into a much more detailed explanation of each lead's use and the mechanics of each type of shading as we progress into Lesson 2. For now, I just want you to learn the 10-value scale and get acquainted with your pencil set. For sixth value, I'll use a 2B lead. The 2B pencil is right in the middle of the spectrum and, in my opinion, the most versatile lead. You'll see me use it or a 3B lead to do most of my preliminary drawing and sketching in this course. That's why I suggested you buy a mechanical 2B pencil on the supply list. I'm still gradually building up to the darkness of the value, but my shading is going to become much more linear as the leads get harder, so more of a cross-hatching technique, which for beginners is just short straight lines. The reason I use hatching instead of scumbling is because making random circles will leave a patchy pattern behind, which can be difficult to smooth out. And remember, your job in this lesson is to keep the value in the square consistent. Just keep building, and when it matches the value of the square on the left, move on to fifth value. For fifth value, I'm going to use a B lead. It's a hard lead, so do your best to keep the value consistent. And for those of you who are just learning shading, don't be afraid to experiment a little. For fourth value, I'll move to the F lead pencil. Again, it's a very hard lead, so I'm going to crosshatch the value in. Harder leads make finer, lighter lines and leave no grain. The more passes you make over the square, the more consistent and solid the value will be. Sorry, I forgot to write down the leads next to the values. Sixth value was a 2B. Fifth value was a B lead. And fourth value is an F. Make sure you write all those leads down on your chart as well. This is going to come in handy throughout the rest of the course. For third value, I'll use an H lead. With a lead this hard, you can only shade with straight lines, or the value will be inconsistent and patchy. But you're probably starting to see the harder the lead is, the easier it is to crosshatch with. This is the lightest lead we'll end up using in most of the course. It can pretty easily cover the spectrum of lighter values on its own. Some of you may be wondering what you could even use a lead this light for. You're going to be amazed how often I use this pencil. White cheeks, the white part of a person's eye, skin tones, mid-tones, and detail in lighter areas. The H lead is one of my favorites. The better you get at shading, the fewer pencils you'll need. As I said earlier, each one of these pencils is capable of covering a spectrum of values. So, for example, once you get some practice, you'll be able to use a 2B or 3B pencil to cover all your shading from 7th value to 10th value, or an H lead to cover 2nd to 4th value. And finally, as you can see, I've switched to a 4H pencil to shade in the 2nd value square. This lead is so hard I doubt it could go higher than 2nd value without ripping through the paper. But now that you know your lead weights, could you imagine using a 6B lead to shade in this square? It would be impossible. Okay, that's 2nd value, and 1st value is just the white paper. Be sure to label the last two boxes with the pencil leads you use to shade them. And you just created a 10 value grayscale. Now that you've gotten acquainted with the different leads in your pencil set, you're ready to learn the mechanics of shading. Be sure to keep this worksheet because in the next few lessons, I'll show you how to use it to help you master shading and control line weight. To try my guided drawing and painting courses, ask me questions, and even get coaching and critiques on your work, visit my website www.artacademy.thinkific.com, look for my courses on Udemy, or just click on the link below.